I'm Brian Pichot, a product manager for App Studio here at Pega, and I'm joined by Sam Tremlett, a senior product architect.
How's it going?
Today we're going to be talking about high productivity with low code. Sam's going to walk us through a different scenario or two, showing how App Studio can be used to be able to really accomplish some amazing tasks quickly.
Why it's becoming so important for low code to enable pro devs to be more productive is we start to see a discrepancy in what IT can deliver versus what the business is demanding. In fact, Gartner said in 2017 that they expect by 2021 to have outgrown that need by 5 times. So we really have to start picking up the pace with our development. We typically see 3 different types of personas when we're doing development. We see the citizen developer, the professional developer, and enterprise IT. I think for today's session, we'll be focusing on how to make professional developer and enterprise IT more efficient using some of our low-code tools. In Pega, we have a bunch of different studios that are designed to be aimed towards making certain personas that we just discussed more productive. So we have App Studio, which is designed for all of those 3, both the citizen developer, enterprise IT, and professional developer. We have Dev Studio, which I'm sure most people are familiar with. That's the one that's probably been around the longest, and that's really geared towards the professional developer and enterprise IT. And then we have Admin Studio and Prediction Studio that help for other things, but outside of the context of this tech talk.
And all of these studios are part of the base platform?
They are, yep.
Excellent.
And the reason it's important to use the right studio when you're doing your development is each one is geared to accelerate development for certain tasks. So if you're doing everything in Dev Studio, while you might be able to accomplish your tasks, chances are it's taking you a lot longer than you actually need to be doing. So if let's say an average project takes around 10 days to do using a lot of Dev Studio and maybe intermittent App Studio and Admin Studio when you need, by switching to the right studios and doing the things in App Studio that you should be doing versus Dev Studio, you can even cut down that time to, let's say, 2 days. And by doing that, you have more time to do other projects and get more people involved.
So by using the right studios, the different personas can get involved in projects and accelerate the actual development and delivery of each of the individual opportunities.
Yes. All right, so I'm going to hop into a demo now. I have a sample application here. It's a job manager, and we're going to go in through App Studio just to show some of the tools that maybe the traditional professional developer doesn't realize is in App Studio now. App Studio has come a long way since it was previously known as Pega Express. There's a lot more functionality in there, not just for the citizen developer, but also for the professional developer to help accelerate your development. So I'm going to start by creating a new data type. To do this, you go to the data type tab, and we're going to start by clicking the new here. And I'm just going to give this a name. This is a job manager, so I'm going to say a job posting will be our data type here. And I'm going to define my source of this data later. So you can either define it now or later.
Why would you want to define it later? Why not define it now?
Yeah, so a lot of times when you're initially creating a data type, you know you need an external integration, but you may not know like all the details yet. Maybe you don't know the authentication yet. You don't know where exactly the system is. Someone's still configuring that. By defining it later, you can set up the integration and stub it out without having to actually wait for all the other kind of integration requirements that go along with it.
So it's really putting a mock in place in order for you to be able to move forward with your application.
Exactly, yep. Once we have this data type, we just define the various fields that we want to put on here. So, you know, again, this is a job posting. I'm going to put in a job title, a job description, and years of experience. These also helps you separate your data model from your source's data model. So if you have some back-end system that constantly changes their model, you don't have to update your system as much if you define your own kind of data structure. And we'll go into the mapping of that in a little bit. Next, we're going to just create simulated data sources. Again, because we're not actually setting up the real integration now, Pega allows us to create sample records in there. So okay. As other people are doing development and you're doing development, you can kind of get some feel with some actual data that's there.
So again, this is more part of the mock, making sure that you actually have some information to be able to see something actually working.
Exactly. And maybe you have some downstream data that is affected by what you enter here. So this will help you kind of stage that up so you can continue until you're ready to put in the real integration.
And get into the right different flows and processes that you want to based on the results.
Exactly, yep. Okay, so then next what we're gonna do is for this data type that we just created, we're gonna define a view for it to have kind of a universal representation of the data that's being pulled back.
So the value of this is what? I define this at one place and then I'm able to then reuse it
yep.
for any data integration that's able to, that's gonna use this data type?
Exactly, and it'll also help kind of centralizing what how you wanna display this data throughout your application. So even if you make changes later, you only have to update something in one spot. And we'll show how this kind of connects here. So I'm just gonna add the three fields that we talked about earlier, title, description, and years of experience. And then we're gonna give this a name, posting view for now. Again, this is job postings. So now we've created this view. And we can go back to our case type now, this job application, and hook this view up so that we start to be able to utilize what we just created. So I'm gonna create a new property here. I'm gonna call it posting, and I'm gonna make a data reference. Data references are just point to either cases that you already have in the application or data types. So I'm gonna select our posting one we've just created. And then I'm gonna go edit a view of the current case type we're on, the job application, and add the view we created in the posting itself to the screen. So I scroll down, I add my new data reference here. And you can see now the view that we created earlier is available for me to choose.
So that's really powerful, where you can actually just quickly be able to integrate the data type that you just created and mocked out directly into a case and be able to leverage that to be able to create some information. But you've now just stubbed this out. So this is really just a mock. Mm-hmm. Have I just given myself a whole bunch of work now that I'm going to have to do again to be able to restructure this in order to be able to use the actual live integration?
Not if you're going through App Studio. So in a moment, I'll show how we convert that simulated integration into a real integration and how easy it is. Just also showing in the demo that here's the simulated data we have so that when we hook up the real data, you can see the difference between the two. So let's address that. Let's start to go back into our data views and change what was previously a simulated integration to a real one. So I do that by replacing the source on the different data pages that have been created for this data type. I'll start with the list. I'm going to define a new system for this. Theoretically, you could imagine going out to one of these customers that have a job application website or some integration that you're looking to use.
Indeed or LinkedIn or something along those
exactly,
lines.
Yep.
And these endpoints could be anything. So here you're coming from a mock. So if I had a soap service or something along those lines that was previous to my data source. Could I then change that out to be able to connect to a REST service using this?
Yep, you can replace the source at any time as you want, even if you have maybe a REST source that's pointing towards dev data and you want to switch it towards production data, you can do that as well.
Oh, wow.
So you just start by giving the endpoint of the integration that you're going to. This one requires authentication, so I'm going to provide those details as well. So once we provide those details and we successfully connect to that endpoint, the next thing we get is this nice data mapping screen. This allows us to get a live response from the service and map those into our existing data type.
So where is this data coming from that's actually getting pulled back, the different fields?
Yeah, so this would be coming from your Indeed or your LinkedIn, the actual service that you're connecting to.
So I'm able to see my data model for my application and then choose which data I want from the source?
Yep, and you can even create new, if you're missing a field here and you need to create new fields in your data type, you can do that from here as well.
Oh.
So I'm gonna just map over all of the different properties that we have. And I should also mention that this is an experience that only exists in App Studio. Again, this is some of the things that help accelerate even professional developers by using App Studio.
So I'm watching you do this, and I'm wondering how many rules are going to be created underneath. Like, what would that process look like in DevStudio? How many rules and different steps would I need to go through to be able to create that same integration there?
Yeah, quite a bit is the answer. So, I mean, I think anyone who's had experience going through DevStudio to do this kind of thing, you're creating REST connectors, you're creating data pages, you're creating sections, you're creating properties for each of the fields, the classes you also have to set up. Then you have to set up new tables to actually add the records to. So it's a lot of work. And I mean, this is something we can accomplish in App Studio in a matter of minutes, right?
It's really powerful.
Yeah. So now if I go back to my case, now that I've put in, replaced our integration with a real one, and I go back to the job posting view, we can see that now we're getting records from our actual live integration. I didn't have to update any of my UI. I didn't have to update it in my data model. It was just as simple as replacing the source.
So that's great and all. So you've shown one thing in App Studio that's really powerful, but I can't do everything in App Studio. We kind of know that. So what do I do next? What happens if I do need to go into Dev Studio? I mean, is that going to be complicated?
No, not at all. So let me actually show you how we integrate the two. And I would say there's also kind of a myth that DevStudio and App Studio can't be used together, which is not the case at all. In fact, if we go into our case designer and we look at one of our stages, we can actually jump directly into DevStudio from App Studio to do something more complicated. So let me show in this case, I'll add a utility that we have. You can imagine this being a more complicated process.
So, but now I'm making this change in App Studio, in Dev Studio. Am I totally invalidating this from App Studio at this point in time? So I make a change in Dev Studio. I can't then change that again in App Studio, can I?
You can, actually. So I think that's another one of the myths that we're trying to get away from. So I've added in this utility in Dev Studio, this print visitors pass, theoretically this more complicated utility that couldn't be done in App Studio. So if I switch back to App Studio now and look at my case again, I can see that this step has been entered there. And now what I'll do is I'll actually add another automation through App Studio into the same spot we just added something in Dev Studio, just to show how those two things interact with each other. So you can see it allows me to enter it without any issue. I can even move it, you know, right next to the thing we just did in Dev Studio. And if we flip back into Dev Studio to see what actually happened there, you can see that it's been added into that flow, and those two things can play nicely together.
So, you know, as a pro dev, do I have the ability then to be able to maybe publish components if I wanted to be able to have someone include into one of their processes? Or is that, since I build that in Dev Studio, it cannot be consumed in App Studio?
No, that's a great question. You can, actually, using relevant records. So whenever you create something in App Studio, the way it gets propagated up to make it easy to use is it marks it as relevant. So you can do the same thing in Dev Studio. If you create a reusable integration, or in this case, you know, we're printing a visitor's pass for the job, you could mark that as relevant, and then everyone else who's just using App Studio or using a combination of the two could start using that as well.
Thank you, Sam, for joining us for this Tech Talk and showing us how pro devs can achieve high productivity with low code.
Thanks, Brian.
If you have any questions, you can always reach out to techtalk@pega.com. And if you are interested in watching any other Tech Talk videos, you can find them on the Pega community in the video library. Thank you.